All right, so I'm going to take a look at patterns. So as usual, go ahead and make a tab in your notebook and cut it down to the margin and all the way down. All right, then pause the video and copy this down. Copy that down. And this is a listening check. Do not copy example 4. Here's my example. Alright, so the first thing is you're going to label the number of terms. You're going to start from 0. You're going to write, if they have any pictures, you're going to write numbers. And you're going to check geometric, then arithmetic. Now, you have linear, quadratic, cubic, and exponential. Linear is y equals mx plus b. Quadratic has a square term in it. So, for example, like 2x squared. Cubic has a cubed term in it, to the power of 3, so for example, 2x cubed. And exponential is raised to the power of an x. It's raised to the power of an x, so 2 raised to x plus 1. Alright, so when you're looking at these functions, okay, linear is going to be arithmetic, but we're going to actually deal with that in the next video. Geometric is going to be exponential. And all you have to do is check for certain things. So if you're looking for linear, you check first differences, quadratic second differences, cubic third differences, and exponential ratio. And you want to always check geometric before you check arithmetic, right? But this only works when there's a constant change in the exercise as well. So let's take a look at that. We have negative 4 to 0. What's the change from negative 4 to 0? It's adding 4. Right? Then from 0 to, and the way you do that is you take the second number, subtract the first number. Just put that in the calculator, 0 minus negative 4. So from 4, from 0 to 4 is plus 4 again. Then from 4 to 8 is plus 4. You can see it's changing by. So now if I need to fill out the next 3 boxes, obviously it would just keep changing by 4. So to get the next box, I'll just add 4 to it, and then add 4 to that, and add 4 to that. So 12 plus 4 would give me 16, plus another 4 would give me 20, and plus another 4 would give me 24. Right, once I've established that, but you, if you have a table, you have to establish that there's a constant change before you can do anything else. So you want to check for exponential. Exponential is ratio. What you do is you take the second number and you divide it by the first. And then the number after that divided by the number after that. If you get the same thing, then it's exponential. But you can see it gives you different numbers. So it's not exponential. So now we're going to check if it's arithmetic, or rather if it has a first difference, a second difference, etc. So you take the second number and subtract it by the first number. Then the third number subtracted by the second number. 32 minus 4, then 108 minus 32. And you can see those numbers are all different. So it's not a first difference. That means it's not a linear. Now I'm going to check if it's quadratic, which means a second difference, meaning you do it again. So second number minus the first number, 0. Third number minus the second number. So 28 minus 4, 24. All right, next number minus that previous number. So 76 minus 28, 48. And do you see if they're changing at the same rate? They are not. So because they're not changing at the same rate, it's not quadratic. So now we're going to check the third difference, which means we're going to check it a third time. So the first one's the first one, this one's the second one, and now we're going to do it a third time. So again, second number minus the first number. So 24 minus 0 is going to be 24. Then 48 minus 24, that's going to give me 24. And you can see that now it's the same. Once they are the same, then you have figured out what kind of function it is. So this is a cubic function, because it's a third difference. It takes 3 times for the numbers to be the same. Okay. Now use that to figure out the next one. So it's going to change by 24 each time. So that's going to be plus 24, plus 24, plus 24. Then you just add it onto what you already have. So you have 48 plus 24, 72 plus 24, because it keeps changing by 24, right? The listening check, color in the 3 empty boxes in the table. 96 plus 24. 260. Now you take the number above it and you add those numbers to it. So it'll be where you stopped last, which was 76 plus 72, because that's what we're doing now. It's going to give you 148. Then that 148 plus, what's the next number underneath it? 96. That's going to give me 244. Take that number plus, how does it change now? 216. That's going to give me 460. Now fill in the top part. So it's going to be 108 plus what? What's the new number? 148. And then you get that answer. Then it's going to be 256 plus what's the new number? to 44. So that's going to be 500. Then finally, 500 plus, what's the last number? 460 is going to be 960. So you can use what you have to fill in the next three numbers. And we're going to do the same thing here. Now, this time it's not a table, it's a sequence, so there's no change in X, but I'm still checking the same things. Is it a geometric term, meaning when I divide the second by the first, do I get a constant? So let's check that. 1/2, and remember, always put fractions in parentheses. I get 4. So then check 2 divided by the one before it, 1/2, I get 4 again. Check the next one, and don't assume, check every one of them. So 32 divided by 8 is 4. And so you can see it's changing by the same constant term. So this is a geometric term. Therefore, it's an exponential function, because every single time I'm multiplying by 4. So now to get the next three numbers, I just need to multiply it by 4. So I take 32 and multiply by 4 to give me the next number. So let's name check color in cubic function, 128. 128 multiplied by 4 will give me the next number. 512 multiplied by 4 will give me the next number. That's pretty much it. So this is an exponential function. Why? Because it's a geometric term. How I get from one number to the next is by multiplying. The listening check put a box around exponential function. We're going to take a look at another two examples in the next video. We're going to talk about all the ways you can see the question. Let's practice.